I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved, just like a tree planted by the water. I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved, just like a tree planted by the water. I shall not be moved. Jesus is my Savior. I shall not be moved. Jesus is my Savior. I shall not be moved, just like a tree planted by the water. I shall not be moved. Jesus is my captain. I shall not be moved. Jesus is my captain. I shall not be moved, just like a tree planted by the water. I shall not be moved. Well, I'm on my way to heaven. I shall not be moved. Well, I'm on my way to heaven. I shall not be moved, just like a tree planted by the water. I shall not be moved. Amen, 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 amen. Here we are, those that are out in cyberspace, God bless you. We're here at First Antioch Baptist Church. Amen. We got a few faithful folks that are here on this afternoon. Let me hear from you. God bless you. Come on, let's clap your hands. Amen. Amen. They wanted to come and be a part of the service. We had an awesome prayer. You are welcome. We have a big space here, and it's easy for us to practice social distancing. And so those that are here are welcome. We have suspended our bus service until further notice, so you're going to have to sort of find your own way here, but you are welcome every Sunday. We've even adjusted for the late risers. We actually start at noon, and so you can come out to the, we have prayer, we have an extended prayer. We really reach out to the Lord. We wait on the Lord. We wait on the Lord until the Holy Ghost say stop. Amen. So the Holy Ghost say, stop. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The great thing about it is we don't really have a schedule. I've been off work. I've been working at home. So I haven't been going into the university. I've been able to teach online. So that's given me more time to pray and for the word. And I'm not always in such a hurry. And so we're here today. Doing what God told us to do. Let us go into the Word. If you could, get your Bibles, turn to Isaiah chapter 40. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 28. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 28. And I'm going to deal with a topic that I have dealt with before, but I revised it in light of the coronavirus. I'm going to deal with the topic. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? God is still God in this corona pandemic. God is still God in this corona pandemic. Let's go to Isaiah 40 and verse 28. Chapter 40, verse 28. God is still God in this corona pandemic. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? Let me read. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is he weary? There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, the hearing, but more so the doer of his holy word. There's a lot of people that doubt the existence of God. The scientists go into their laboratories. They use physics and mathematics. I remember when I was in college and I liked science, I liked chemistry, and I liked physics, except when it got to the math part. I didn't realize that when you do organic chemistry, because I like to put chemicals together, and that was fun to me, you know, blow stuff up and stuff smoking. And one time we in organic chemistry class, we extracted the caffeine out of coffee. My teacher was a scientist, and she showed us how to a process of how they take the caffeine out of coffee and decaffeinate it. That was so cool. But when we got to the math, like how to explain it, I was like, can I drop the class? I had to stick it out, though. That class was so difficult. We had to form study groups in every single class. We had to meet after class and study what she just taught us. And so scientists, they think they have it all figured out. The chemists and the physicists, they think they have it all figured out. There can't be a God because we can't see him. There can't be a God because we can't touch him. There can't be a God because we can't hear him. But there's one thing they forgot. You say you can't hear him. You say you can't feel him. You can't touch him. But I can feel him. I can feel him in my hands. I can feel him in my feet. I can feel him all over me. And Jeremiah said it's just like fire shut up in my bones. And if you've never experienced the Holy Ghost. Somebody was talking about the Holy Ghost. Every believer has a little bit of the Holy Ghost. That's what brings you to be saved. But we need the baptism of the Holy Ghost. We need to be baptized in the Holy Spirit. We need the Lord to fill us with the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is the keeper. And that's what keeps you. And then the Holy Ghost tells you when you should walk away. And we need more of the Holy Ghost in our life. That's what's going on. We need to be filled with his Spirit. That's what we were starting to talk about. And the Lord, he's drawing us. He's drawing some of us. But there's a lot of people that want to explain away the existence of God. And I can't understand, even during COVID-19, why people wouldn't understand that God is real. Why they wouldn't see God being in a pandemic. Why are people so eager to get back to business as usual? The world is already so messed up. Amen. We have to be careful if we can't miss what God is trying to say to us. Amen. One of the things God is trying to do with this pandemic is get our attention. He's reminding us that he's on the throne. I can guarantee one thing, that if God keeps this virus around long enough, he will definitely get our attention. He will be the one to open the city back up. He'll be the one to make things back to normal if he wants to. But we're never going to be fully back to normal. It's just like after 9/11, the airports weren't the same anymore. There's a lot of things that changed after 9/11. We can never go back to that time again. He'll be the one. People have the illusion that they're actually in control. The government has the illusion that they're in control. The mayor of the city, the governor, they feel like they're the ones that's opening the city back up. And God gave them a certain amount of authority to do things, but really, ultimately, he's the one that's in control. The atheist, or the one that believes, that does not believe in God, they try to explain God away. They try to make excuses to justify their sin. Just because they don't believe in God does not change the fact that he's real. Just their unbelief does not change anything. God is the one that's in control. They may try to escape from him, but he's everywhere. Psalms 139 and 7, whither shall I go from thy spirit? Or whither shall I flee from thy presence? If I ascend up into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea. Verse 11 of Psalms 139 says, if I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, even the night shall be light about me. We can't get away from his presence. Amen. Verse 28, hast thou not known? Going back to our main text, Isaiah 28 and 28. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? That's a question. Isaiah opens with a rhetorical question that seems to say, don't you know? Haven't you heard? Then the author goes on to describe the Lord. He's the everlasting God. He's the Lord of the universe. He sits outside of the affairs of men. He's not relegated to human politics. He's not restrained by Republican politics. He's not restrained by Democratic politics. He doesn't need the Senate to pass a bill. He can do what he wants to do. He's bringing the Republicans and Democrats together, whether they like it or not. Somehow or another, they came together and passed two bills already. We're working on our third stimulus bill. Somehow or another, those conservatives, those fiscal conservatives that are reluctant to give anybody anything, they have the mindset that everybody's lazy, they need to work for everything, single thing they get, even though they were handed everything to them as a child. But they so reluctant. They always think that African Americans and the poor are getting over on them. So they don't want to give any handouts, but all of a sudden during the pandemic, everybody getting a check. That's God. They did it reluctantly. But the Lord sent the pandemic. And all of a sudden, Nancy Pelosi, the minority leader, sat down with Mitch McConnell, the majority leader. They struck 2-3 deals. God did it. Who did it? God did it. Who did it? Who did it? God did it. God did it. Who did it? Who did it? God did it. God did it. God did it. Isaiah 40 and 21. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Then he said this, have it not been told you from the beginning? Have ye not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is he that sitteth, look at verse 22. It is he that sitteth upon the circle of the earth. Woo-wee! The circle of the earth. They used to think that the earth was flat. But here we are in ancient times, reading an ancient text that's nearly 3,000 years old. Isaiah was written about 3,000 years ago, maybe 2.5 millennia ago. And Isaiah already understood that the earth was round. Christopher Columbus in the 14th, humanity, the Spanish Empire, the so-called sophisticated modern people of the 1500s and 1600s still were talking about the earth being flat. All they had to do was go back to Isaiah and read this passage and see that the earth was a circle. He said, God sitteth upon the circle of the earth. The inhabitants thereof are as grasshoppers that stretches out the heavens as a curtain and spread them out as a tent to dwell in. Verse 23, that bringeth the princes to nothing. He can bring the powerful to nothing. Verse 23 says that. He can take the senators. He's already taken senators to judgment already. There's already been several senators in recent past that have gone into judgment from Congress. There's already been presidents that have passed away. Ronald Reagan, back in the 80s, as powerful as he was, he had to meet death at some point. So many that have gone. Michael Jackson, Prince, the artist formerly known as Prince, Whitney Houston. I've been reading about all the stars that have gone to judgment. He bringeth the princes to nothing. That's the rich and powerful. He maketh the judges of the earth as vanity. They don't mean anything to him. God doesn't really need me. He doesn't need any of us. He's God all by himself. He don't need nobody else. He's the creator of the ends of the earth. Creation testifieth of his existence. Creation points to the magnificence of God. He created the bald eagle that once was an endangered species. The bald eagle used to be on the endangered species list. Those that understand science, you know that when an animal is endangered, that means it's almost going into extinction. Like the passenger pigeon. The passenger pigeon is no longer on this earth. The last passenger pigeon was at the Cincinnati Zoo back in the early 20th century, I think the 1920s, and it died. And therefore, because of humanity's destruction, that species is no longer on the earth. The bald eagle, even as recent as the 80s and 90s, they thought the bald eagle was going to be extinct, so they began to pass various laws to protect it. Now, because of the Lord, we have so many bald eagles again. They proliferated right in Butler County, Ohio. We have bald eagles. God created the magnificent, majestic bird that we call the bald eagle. He can soar above the purple mountains and the majesty. Indeed, the Lord said to Israel in Exodus 19 and 4, he said, you have seen what I did to the Egyptians and how I bore you up on eagle's wings and brought you to myself. The Lord can bring us up on eagle's wings above the pandemic. The Lord can bring us up on eagle's wings and fly above the circumstances. But not only did he create the bald eagle, he created the various species of flowers. He created the tiger lily. He created the daffodil. He created the roses are red, violets are blue. He loves you and I do too. The Lord created the Venus flytrap. He created the iris, the ginger, the orchid. He created the baby's breath. The Lord created the chrysanthemum and the carnation. He is a master artist. God has even caused flowers to grow in Death Valley. In Death Valley, the temperature is as high as 134 degrees. On record. In Death Valley, he created flowers even there. The desert star, the blazing star in Death Valley, the desert gold, and even the primrose, the evening primrose. He created 37 species of foxes, from the red fox to the Arctic fox to the sand fox, the crab-eared fox. He's a master artist. Has thou not known? hast thou not heard? He's still God during the pandemic. He created, thank you, Jesus. He created the white-tailed deer, the Bengal tiger, the Ethiopian wolf, the black-backed jackal, and the duck-billed platypus. He created the bare-necked fruit crow, the black-bellied whistling duck, and the snub-nosed monkey. He is so sophisticated, he created the long-necked giraffe and the fat Asian elephant and the hippopotamus. And at the same time, he created the humpback whale. And he stooped way down and created the worker ant. And then he came up a little bit and created the honeybee. And he said, you take your little wings and your stinger, you figure out how to make something that's sweet as honey in a honeycomb. And then he reached way over in the corner when nobody could see in the shadow, and he created the black widow spider. He created the hummingbird and the bumblebee and the single-celled organisms. He created the amoeba and the slime mold. He created the algae and the fungi. He's God all by himself. Amen. He don't need anybody else. Men can spend all night in the laboratory. They can take all month long. And they can't even create a bumblebee out of scratch. That showed you how bad God is. Hallelujah. Thank you. I'm feeling this thing today. God created the cell structure with the nucleus and the cytoplasm, the cell wall and the cell membrane, the nucleus membrane and the chloroplasm. He created humans in all shapes and sizes. He created the European men, the Scotsman, the Irish, the Italian, the Norwegian, folk of African descent, the Ethiopian, the Nigerian, thank you, Lord, the Somalian. He created the Kenyan, the African American. And when we used to say, nobody knows the trouble I've seen. Nobody knows but Jesus. He put the song in the black man's heart. Hallelujah, down in the valley, I didn't go to stay. My soul got happy and I stayed all day. He created the Chinese man, the Japanese and the Vietnamese man, the Arabian and the Venezuelan, and the Mexican to say, como estás? Muy bien, gracias. Usted, me llamo David. He created different languages. And he's so simple, but he's yet complex. The simplicity of a complex God. He created all the stars and the moons, and not just one galaxy, but galaxies, plural. The Milky Way, and the other ways out there, and the planet Pluto, and Uranus, and Saturn, and Mercury. And he created Texas, and California, and Madagascar, and Sri Lanka. And he's so complex, but he's simple. And at the end of the day, he sits around, he counts the hairs on our heads. He is so sophisticated. He created an entire universe. But he can take our sinful black hearts, apply his red blood, and make us as white as snow. Are you glad about it? Are you glad about it? Has thou not known? Has thou not heard? Oftentimes we try to resolve situations ourselves. And God just simply wants us, simply steps out of the way. Let us try to fix problems and we make it even worse. He patiently waits for us until we're ready to turn the situation over to him. He's never too tired. Never too busy to help or listen. Verse 29 says this, he giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases strength. The faint that are stricken with COVID-19, There was one woman, I got the report, that she was so scared when they put her on a ventilator. She was so afraid that when she couldn't breathe, when COVID took her breath, they turned her on her stomach, she couldn't get any relief. We don't have to be afraid. We got Jesus on our side. And some the Lord has chosen to take home. But I'm not worried about that. And yes, I want to be around, but I got the Lord, and I know where I'm going. Even, now listen, even the strongest people get tired at times. Even the strongest people are afraid. No sense of us talking big and overly spiritual. We have some good days and some bad days. Some days we're afraid, some days we're on the mountain. But God's power never diminishes. And his power don't waver like ours. His emotions don't waver like ours. His power and strength never diminishes. Even young people with all their energy and idealism get tired. Even a youth shall faint. The thing about youth is when you are young, you do not realize that you will not always have all that strength and vitality. But young people don't waste your time. To those out there listening, don't waste your time in your life in the world. The devil will beat you up and take all your strength. But it's never too late to obey God. No matter how old you are, God says, stop running, do what God told you to do. Sometimes people get there 5 years later. Sometimes people get there 20 years later. They say, okay, God, I'm ready. But the sooner the better. The blessing might not come overnight. In fact, it may seem like folk out in the world getting away with not honoring God. But by and by, according to Galatians 6:7, we'll all reap what we sow. The sooner you start consistently obeying the Lord, the sooner you will be blessed. In Psalms 121:8, David said, the Lord will preserve or bless my coming out and my coming in. Everywhere you go, you'll be blessed when you serve the Lord and are in his will. It doesn't matter what the situation looks like. The bills may be due. Corona might be knocking at your door. Some people talk about Corona like it's a person. It may be knocking at your door. Hallelujah, don't matter though. God is bigger than Corona. And he's still God, even in this pandemic. I'm so glad I serve a God that doesn't step out when the pandemic comes. I'm so glad that the Lord don't tip out when it's a pandemic. I'm so glad that when I pray, he don't have restaurant out of business sign at his door. He don't have an out of business sign in heaven. Hallelujah. He don't cancel me when my insurance run out. The Lord don't turn off my food supply when I forgot to reapply for my Ohio card. He don't cancel my services when my Medicare or Medicaid run out. He's always there. God's blessings are not contingent on your circumstances. You're blessed because his word says you're blessed by your obedience. 1 Samuel 15:22 states, behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to hearken than the fat of rams. So obedience is better than sacrifice. And as I close, that end part says, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. If you wait on your deliverance in prayer, God will see you through. If you wait on your breakthrough, God will renew your strength. Sometimes you got to start all back over. Say, Lord, I'm putting myself on the altar again because I want you to bless me. I don't want to miss any of the blessings you have for me. So I'm going to start this thing all over. A lot of times we get ahead of the Lord and we try to fight our own battles. But wait on your help. Sometimes we can spend 10, 20 years doing things our way and never giving our hearts fully to God. We do things our way, but give it to Jesus. Give it to Jesus. Give your life to Him. Actually turn over the reins and the steering wheel to Jesus. If you wait on God, you'll mount up with wings as eagles. That's victory flying high above the devil in the Lord. Flying high above the devil on God's side. Flying high over your struggles. Flying on eagle's wings over addiction. Flying high over people. Flying high over COVID-19. High over the president of the United States. That stuff don't faze us. You're flying so high up in the Lord and filled with His Spirit, the devil can't even touch you. You'll run the Christian race and not get tired. Walk the righteous life and not faint. When folk trying to get us to go back out there, you hold on. Amen. Let go and let God. And as I close, hold on when the going gets tough. Amen. Hold on when the going gets rough. Amen. Hold on when your lights get cut off. Amen. Hold on when you get a little cough and you feel like it's COVID-19. Hold on when you got a high temperature and you start getting scared. Hold on, my brother. Hold on, my sister. God is still God, even during COVID-19. Hold on, because one of these mornings, it won't be long. You're going to look for me, and I'll be gone. You see, this world is not my home. I love this world. I love to take walks in the sunlight. I love to go to Wynton Woods Park. I love to spend time with my children. I love the beauty of this world. But this is not my home. As a Christian, this is not our home. I'm going home to be with Jesus. So don't worry about it. Give it to the Lord. He'll work it out. He will work it out. He's in charge no matter what. Remember, He's the one in charge. In Jesus' name, God bless you. God bless your heart. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord. Glory to your name. Hold to His hand. God's unchanging hand. Hold to His hand, God's a changing hand. Build your hopes on things eternal. Hold to God's a changing hand. Well, hold to His hand. God's a changing hand. Hold to His hand. God's a changing hand. Build your hopes on things eternal. Hold to God's a changing hand. Amen. Man, let us pray. Every head is bowed, every eye is closed. Heavenly Father, we thank You that You have let us make it this far. Maybe some didn't think they would make it to the year 2020. Indeed, back in the 90s, those that grew up in the 80s and 90s, even the 70s, the year 2020 seemed like the future. But here we are, walking around the earth, in the midst of a disease outbreak, and You've been keeping us.
Thank You.
Lord, if You kept us, You kept some through the Vietnam War, You kept some through the Persian Gulf crisis, You kept some through heartbreak, hotel, some through evictions, addictions, and You brought us here. We can make it through COVID-19. And Lord, but we're not unwise. We're gonna wash our hands, we're gonna put our mask on, we're going to practice social distancing, and we're not going to just run back out because the government said run back out. but we're going to trust in you. And Lord, we pray for those families that have lost loved ones recently, all of the people, the almost 100,000 people that have died in the United States, the 91,000 that have died in the United States as a result of COVID-19, we pray for their families. Those fathers, those mothers, those daughters, those grandparents, those grandchildren that no longer has that individual in their life. Those congregations all over the state and the country that have lost pastors through COVID-19. We pray that they would be comforted. Those in the congregation that has lost loved ones, that have people sick as a result. Lord, rebuke the fear. We know that you're the God over COVID-19. You're in charge still. We ask that you would strengthen us on today. Lord, look on those that had just given their life to Christ. They're making a new step, and they need the Lord in their life. They need the guidance of the Holy Spirit. Let them walk in you. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Man, God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. I'm going to do a benediction. May the Lord watch between me and thee while we're absent, one from another. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you.